Can you run it?
I want to ask Mr. Short, what do you consider on behalf of the good staff or the ordinary staff of RTE, which are all talented, an appropriate sanction from what you're hearing today or what's going to go on and a Grant Thornton report? Do you believe you're going to get accountability from this process?
Yeah, I believe we're going to get accountability with this process, and that's been the intention of the board, at least in beginning the process to bring us to where we're at now. And I fully accept that it's extremely frustrating. It's an ugly process. It's a process that is also dragging the organisation through enormous damage reputationally in terms of staff morale. But if I didn't believe that we were going to get accountability, I wouldn't be engaged in it.
And what do you believe it should look like?
I don't think that's for me to say, because I think there's a process in place where we're getting there. And we've already taken actions that have been called into question in an attempt to try to bring in a level of accountability for the now former Director General. And that wasn't an easy decision to make. And that went through, obviously, we were patiently waiting for the first Grant Thornton report to be completed. And then it went through our own meeting at the Audit and Risk Committee, three full board meetings, which at that stage, the process of accountability, if you want to call it, was underway before we made what was also a very difficult decision to suspend the Director General. And as a member of staff, that is a decision that I can tell you went through a lot of rigorous discussion and was a big decision to make, and we didn't take it lightly.
And I appreciate that, and I can see from your face through this whole thing, this is painful. I can just imagine. It's the deceit. It's the deceit. And the whole thing was designed to deceive you and to make you believe that you had to take your pay cuts because the top talent, as they referred to previously, took them. But at the same time, and you talked about the lengthy process when it came to Miss Forbes that was undertaken, how can we have, or what have we learned? Because the coffers of RTE, as I previously stated, are going to suffer on the basis of compensation that will be paid for that process not being undergone with what Mr. Lynch's actions were, with his, I can't remember who you said, Mr. Lynch, yourself, and who made the decision not to put Mr. Tuberty back in the air?
The Director of Content.
Now, that's going to strain the finances of RTE further, because I'm sure that the government are not going to pick up the tab, nor should they. But it's, what level of learning have we with incompetent decisions? You took weeks as a board for someone who was leaving anyway, 6 weeks from her role being fulfilled as the DG. You took a week to decide on someone who had only 6 weeks left in the role. This decision was made by a board, isn't that correct?
Correct.
This decision that Mr. Lynch has made is made by two people. And it's going to, we're talking about, in your regard, we're talking about a mistake, whatever it's going to be called, but it has cost €150,000. This is going to cost hundreds of thousands, if not millions. And where are we going to see accountability? Because at the end of the day, Mr. Lynch has said he won't resign. He isn't being asked to take a reduction in salary. But when that bill has to be accounted for, who's going to take the reduction in salary and ultimately become accountable other than the people you represent? And I don't call that accountability. And I don't know what accountability looks like here. But I know certainly there's nobody in front of me going...
Sorry, if I could just go some way to answering that. There's also accountability to the public, and there's accountability to what RTE stands for, which is the truth. And I know that may be difficult for people to accept, given everything that's been happening. But as far as staff are concerned, that's very much what we understand our jobs to be. And I don't know what, as you assert, there may be in terms of the risks that have arisen because of the way that we've dealt with it. But we've made decisions, we felt we had to make decisions. In terms of the decision to regarding Ryan Tuberty and being on air, that wasn't a board decision, nor should it ever be a board decision. The idea that a board would have some say-so in who's on the air in RTE would, quite frankly...
No, you know, I agree with that. I don't
strike
mean
fear
board.
In my heart.
I mean the full executive should have been aware of a decision that was going to pose a payout of hundreds of thousands, if not millions of euros. At the end of this, that will be the end result. There won't be accountability. There'll be nobody sacked because there's already the scapegoats in place.
Well, Deputy, I can only assure you as a board member who is, you know, has a responsibility both to staff but also indirectly through the Minister to the Oireachtas, that accountability will be something that I will be very focused on delivering for staff, for the Oireachtas through the Minister and for the public.
Thank
and
you.
That's why I asked.
Thank
I asked
you.
What it looked like.
We're not there yet, so we can't tell you.
Thank you. Deputy Tilden.
Thank you.